Dimensions, revelation, impartation, manifestation, and complete restoration.
As the manifestation apostle, Evangelist Kehinde Adewale, preached the word with the manifestation of the spirit and power.
For unclean spirits, crying with loud voice, came out of many that were possessed within, and many taken with palsies, and that were lame, were healed.
You can reach God's servant, Evangelist Kehinde Adewale, on his email at adewalekehindeplus@gmail.com or send text message to 0806-833-4602.
And you can worship with us at Charismatic Gospel Evangelistic Ministry behind Akebaje Complex off Abeokuta Lagos Expressway, number 5, Ifedolapo Street, Obada, Ogun State.
Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
We can bear friends his name tonight. He is the Almighty God. He has no rival. Oh, glory be to Jesus. Say something very wonderful. Say something wonderful. He was the one who is the one who is to come. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Jesus Christ, your kind of
He's the one that baptizes with fire.
Oh, no, baptism, but we know.
Oh, thank you, Father.
Show, Baba.
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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father.
Show, Baba.
What you did yesterday.
Thank you, Shelano.
You continue tonight. It shall be great tonight because tonight shall be my night of revival. Revival shall happen to me again. Every lost glories and gifting shall restore. Oh, worship Jesus in anticipation of mighty works. In anticipation of mighty works. In anticipation of miracles. Father, we praise you tonight because we come to us again. Because we visit the church again. Because end time glory power shall be manifested in
our
midst. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Glory be to Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father. Thank you, God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy, Jehovah. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy to be glorified. You are worthy, Jehovah. You are worthy to be glorified.
Thank you.
Father, we thank you tonight because we know that you are the center of this tabernacle. Those who seek me shall find me. Father, we are here in your presence. Until you shall be gatherings of your people. Tonight as we gather, let your glory fall. Father, let your hand fall. Father, let the mighty, tangible, feelable, possible presence of your mighty hand. In the name of Jesus. Tonight,
yes,
do mighty things in our midst. Do mighty things in our midst. Let there be revival. Let there be restoration. Let there be revisitation. Let there be repositioning. Let the church get back its power. Let the church get back its prophecy. In the name of Jesus. Let the destiny of the church be restored again. Thank you, mighty God. Glory be to your name. In Jesus' mighty name. We pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I say shout, not say. I say shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Are you happy to be in church this evening?
Yeah,
were you blessed yesterday? Today shall be greater.
I shall
say today shall be greater. Are you expecting the manifest presence of God? Are you expecting revival in your life? Are you expecting that the oil will flow again? Are you expecting that the power of God will come back again? There shall be restoration. There shall be restraining. There shall be reawakening. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bless God to be here again. Take your seat, sirs and ma'am. It's a great privilege to be in God's presence. And I count it so great privilege to be here. I greatly appreciate the privilege given to me by our Father. Is a father in the body of Christ by the grace of God and over this mission.
He's
one of the end time giant that God has positioned for us. I mean our father in the Lord that the Owade and mommy Owade.
Awon baba wa ati mama wa Owade.
We pray that God will preserve your life for us.
Agbadura Olorun yo pa emi ni mo
fun wa. God will continue to strengthen and to use you mightily.
Olorun yo tesiwaju lati ma lo ni si.
The Lord will open greater doors to nations.
Olorun yo o si ilekun la orilede fun yin.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Oruko nla Jesu.
Thank you so much, sir, for the privilege.
Ade ese o baba fanfani.
I also appreciate God's servant and father here.
A tun dupe lowo awon eyan ti
Pastor James, thank you so much, sir. I also appreciate everyone here tonight. Glory be to God. Tonight, the Lord will continue where we stopped yesterday. What is the theme of the meeting? Can I hear, sir? Fresh oil. Fresh oil. How many of you have begun to feel that revival that has started in your life? Can I see your hand if you have had a feeling revival? Thank you, Father. Don't worry. If you don't add in tonight, God will visit you. And the word continues tonight. And if you not stop till Jesus comes, in the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
Fresh oil. Let Let's read that verse again, Psalm 92. Psalms 92. Psalms 92. We read verse 10. 11. 12. Are we there together? If you are there, say Jesus.
Okay,
let's read. Want to go? Everybody want to go? But my hand shall thou exalt like the horn of an unicorn. I shall be anointed with fresh oil. Verse 11. And I also shall see my Isaiah on my enemies, and my ears shall hear my Isaiah of the wicked that rise up against me. Verse 12. In Lebanon, verse 13. In the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Verse 14. Verse 15, everybody.
It's
my rock, and there is no unrighteousness. Fresh oil is a re-impartation. Fresh oil is a revisitation. Fresh oil is the re-empowerment. Is revival. Is restoration. Is reawakening. It is fresh. It means they used to be.
There
was before.
Oh, what?
Something happened before. The oil has come before. But now, probably something happened. Maybe along the line, the giftings before have departed. Giftings. The fire in your life before has died. The revival of holiness, of righteousness, of repentance has departed. The fire to study the word, to stay with God,
in the presence
of prayer and intercession,
and supplication
has departed. What you have been doing with ease before, you now struggle to do. There is need for fresh oil. That oil that has dried upon your life be revisited, be restored. That oil that has departed, that has gone dry, is renewed. Tonight, that's what God will be doing. Because tonight, God will visit us with His fire, with His power, with His glory, and His presence. In the name of Jesus, tonight, there shall be revival. Someone
said
There shall be restoration. There shall be revival, and there shall be restoration. In the name of Jesus. I'd like to tell you tonight. He said, my head shall be lifted. My arm shall be lifted. My
arm
shall be lifted. My arm shall thou exalt. My strength that has gone down. The power that has departed. As in, what I do with things before, but I struggle to do now.
Nkan ti mo se ni irorun tele ti mo wa n
se back. I can preach from house to house before.
Mo le waasu lati ojule kan
si. I can preach inside a vehicle before.
Mo le waasu ninu moto tele.
But now I feel shy.
Mo ni isisiyi oju n ti.
To declare Jesus in the vehicle.
Lati polongo Kristi ninu moto.
To preach Jesus in the market.
Lati waasu Jesu ni oja.
Tonight, the oil of God,
ororo Olorun,
that oil of revival,
ororo isoji,
shall revisit you again.
Yo be owo lenkan si.
It shall revisit you again.
Yo be owo lenkan si.
It shall revisit you again.
Yo be owo lenkan si.
In the name of Jesus.
Ni oruko nla ti Jesu.
The oil is ororo. not that I told you yesterday. That the oil is not the one in the bottle. The one
we're talking about. Wa ninu igbo la nsoro nipa re o.
It's an emblem of the spirit.
O je en to soju emi.
It's an emblem of the Holy Spirit.
O je en to soju emi mimo.
That is what God said through Joel.
Olorun so nipasẹ
Joel ni le.
Pe ni igba ikeyin.
I will pour.
Emi yo tu.
I will pour.
Emi yo tu.
Say, I will pour out of my spirit.
Emi yo tu emi mi jade.
Someone say, I will pour out.
Emi yo tu emi.
Can I hear you say it loud?
Je ki n gbọ ike so be.
The word pour.
Peter to jade.
Is used for something that you can pour as a liquid.
O je nkan to je bi olomi nkan to nson ni.
Are you getting what I'm saying?
John 10.
Bible is so perfect to make error.
Bíbélì mo pe pere pere kò sí
àṣìṣe nínú ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run. Out of my spirit.
Èmi yóò tú ẹ̀mí mi jáde.
Upon all flesh.
Lérí gbogbo ènìyàn gbogbo.
When it happened on the day of Pentecost.
Ó ṣẹlẹ̀ ní ọjọ́ Pentecost.
Peter received the power.
Pétérù ó gbàgbára yìí.
All the 120 persons they received the power.
Gbogbo àwọn ọgọ́fà ìwọ̀n gbàgbára.
Peter that could not stand. Before a young girl.
Pétérù tí ò lè dúró níwájú ọmọ kékeré.
To confirm Jesus.
Láti sọ nípa Jésù.
He stood one time.
Ó dúró ní ọjọ́ kan ṣoṣo.
He declared Jesus.
Ó sọ̀rọ̀ nípa Jésù.
And all nothing less than 3,000 persons.
Ó lé ní ẹgbẹ̀rún mẹ́ta ènìyàn.
Were added to the church immediately.
Láti fojú ìjọ.
Sir, eloquency does not convert souls. Eloquency.
Ẹ̀rọ sísọ kò gbọ́ kan la.
Motivation and psychology and philosophy has black power to win souls.
Ọ̀rọ̀ àforísọ ìmọ̀ ẹ̀kọ́ kò ní agbára láti gbọ́ kan la.
When we preach and nothing happen, we need oil.
Ìgbà tá a bá wọ àtúntì nǹkan kò ṣẹlẹ̀, a nílò òróró.
When we go out to declare Jesus and no soul has been won to Christ, we need the oil.
Ìgbà tá a bá jáde ìwàásù ìyìnrere tí ọ̀kan kan kò wá sínú ìjọ,
a nílò òróró.
Ní ọjọ́ kan ẹ̀kan ṣoṣo, Pétérù dìde láì lo
gbogbo ohun.
Ó wà sún ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run láì fìwé pélébé wà sí. Ó wà sún ìrere láì níwèé
pélébé. Only a few minutes.
Ní àárín ìṣẹ́jú kan.
Oh, nothing less than 3,000.
Kò sí ní ẹgbẹ̀rún mẹ́ta.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ni a fi to Jesus.
Ìṣẹ̀rí bá fún Jésù.
Ẹ̀sà we need the oil upon our lives.
Ó òróró ìlórí ayé wa.
Gbogbo
ẹni tó ń gbọ́ ohun mi ní àṣálẹ́.
Sari lẹ́sẹ̀ fún ẹ̀sìn mi.
Yóò tú òróró ẹ̀ jáde.
The oil of grace and power.
Òróró orí ọ̀fẹ́ àti agbára.
The oil is an enablement.
Òróró yìí jẹ́ okun.
The oil is a license.
Ó jẹ́ nǹkan tó ràn wá lọ́wọ́.
The oil is a strength.
Ó jẹ́ okun.
To do exploit in God.
Láti sun rere fún Ọlọ́run.
The oil.
Òróró.
Is a permission.
Ó jẹ́ àṣẹ.
Is a license.
Ó jẹ́ ìwé ìrìnsẹ̀.
This is what makes difference.
Eléyìí tó mú ìyàtọ̀.
What makes a difference between you and unbeliever is the anointing.
Ìyàtọ̀ láàrin ìwà àtàlà ìgbàgbọ́ ni òróró.
What makes the difference between you and unbeliever and ordinary people is the oil of God upon your life.
Ìyàtọ̀ láàrin ìwà àtàlà ìgbàgbọ́ ni ìfàmì òróró
ni. Mark chapter 1 verse 22.
Nínú òwe Mark oríkìní ẹsẹ̀
kejì ló kọ́. Mark chapter 1 verse 22.
Mark oríkìní ẹsẹ̀ kejì
ló kọ́. Mark chapter 1.
Mark oríkìní.
Verse 22.
Ẹsẹ̀ kejì lè ní
òwe. Mark chapter 1.
Mark o.
And they were astonished at his doctrine. For he taught them as one that has authority. Can I hear? And not as his Christ. Are you catching what I'm saying here? Impose them as the one that has authority.
He
taught them. He was doing teaching. Jesus was teaching people. Not like the way scribes does it. From tonight, after tonight's meeting, everything you do, the anointing of God will back it up. This is what makes the difference between you and natural people. This is what commands the difference. He said, I will put the difference between those who serve you and those who do not. He said, people saw it. They had the teaching.
One
boy, said, this one is different from how you used to hear it. He was teaching them, and he was healing the sick. He was teaching them, he was casting out devils. He was teaching them, the difference between the church and the world is the power of God. The identity of the church, it's not signboard. The identity of the church, it's not signboard. It's not the logo.
The anointing.
David said, The anointing for life challenges. Do you know that money has limitations? Do you know? Do you know that? Even medications, they are limited in power. Only the anointing of God is unlimited. It's limitless. Tonight, the possibility of God, the ability of God, the ability of the divinity, which is the anointing, is the oil. It's a come upon your life. It's a come upon your life. In the name of Jesus.
Our
God anointed Jesus of Nazareth. Our God anointed Jesus of Nazareth. With the Holy Ghost. And what?
Atiagbara.
After that, what happened? Who went? The anointing is the cure for stagnation. With the anointing, no boundary, no limit, no stagnation. When the anointing comes, your destiny is set on course. When the anointing comes, your life is set on motion. When the anointing comes, your voice is empowered to the world. Little things will bring forth results. Can you imagine speaking to somebody? Just one person, and he starts weeping and confess Jesus right instantly. Oh, flesh and blood cannot do that. Eloquency and knowledge cannot do that. PhD, professorial, whatever you carry cannot do that. The only thing that can attempt and do that is the power of God. Is the anointing of God. I told you yesterday that the anointing of the Holy Spirit is the power of God. Is the ability of God. Is the possibilities of God. Is the strength of God. Tonight, to everyone that is down, the anointing will re-empower you. His strength will come upon you again. In the name of Jesus, without the oil, you will lose motion. So you will lose progress. So you will lose advancement. Without the oil, can you imagine a vehicle that is going to Lagos and broke down at Ifo? They said and saw that there is no oil. Can you imagine? Without oil, vehicle cannot move. How much more you? If lack of oil will stop those unwise virgins, from entering, from following and going with their bride, with their group, how much more in this generation? Let me tell you something here. Holy Ghost has come, and that is the power of the church. That is the ability of the church. That is the possibility of God. That is the identity of the church. Tonight, after this meeting, you will go with the strength of God. You will go with the ability of God. You will go with the oil of God. You become the anointing of God. And several things will happen tonight. Everyone that has been stopped. Everyone that has lost motion in life, in God, in destiny. Tonight, by the force of the oil, by the force of the anointing, they shall be pushed advanced. They shall be pushed forward. They shall get their motion. Our God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power. Somebody say, oh Lord, tonight, anoint my head, anoint me with the Holy Ghost and power. Our God anointed Jesus of Nazareth. The Holy Ghost and power. Who went about doing good, healing those who are oppressed of the devil. Listen to me. When the anointing of God is strong upon you, when the oil of God has come very heavy upon your life, impossibilities become possible. Mountains will go down. One time they brought one lady from one hospital in Ikeja. And so they couldn't, they have done everything they could do on her. And right, they brought her to my house. So I didn't know, they didn't even inform me. Somebody just linked them. And the husband carried her inside to the sitting room. I was like, what is? So I was just in my room when somebody just rushed in and said, somebody's in this room. He's about to die. I said, die?
Who?
How? What happened? And then I just put on my shirt fast and rush out. And then I found the lady. The only one I met among them is somebody that we know. The husband, the wife, I don't know them. And the lady was palpitating, almost gassing out, almost passing out. Holy Ghost just spoke to me. Go there and get her healed. Preach under 15 minutes. That palpitation stopped. That about to pass out or something, struggling. Stopped. I didn't know that they carried her inside. Now she wanted to talk to me, and all those men just excused us. So I said, who was that one that went out? Said the husband. He said, what? Go and call your husband. Let's talk together. And she stood up. She stood up. I didn't know that they carried her inside. She stood. And walked and went out to their car. When the husband saw her,
that your quarry,
hey! What is this? And rushed inside.
He
said, this is God. I said, you are correct. This is real miracle. I said, if it is real miracle, then it means it's God. No man can do this kind of a work. These are the possibilities in God. These are things that God does through the anointing. A natural Christian. Listen to me, the difference between a spiritual and a revived Christian and an ordinary Christian, or ordinary.
To come back and watch us,
is the anointing of God.
Okay, for you know, Lord.
Is the hoya. Is the
hoya.
Is the hoya. Tonight. Do you want to be a natural Christian?
Okay, can I hear?
Can I hear? Can I hear? Oh, so you want to be a supernatural Christian? That goes everywhere and things must happen. In the name of Jesus. Even in your place of work, things will be happening there. I said they will know. They are a child of God. For the endless expectations of the creature awaited the manifestations of the sons of God. The endless expectation of the creatures.
They are
waiting the manifestation of the sons of God. So person is in our midst. Why are we not seeing the difference? You want to tell me that they don't know that that Christianity is. There is power in this
individual.
They know. When things happen and you are helpless, they look at you with mysteries like, why are you different from others? And we have received self-same spirit. He said self-same spirit. The same anointing that fell upon the apostles. The same anointing that fell upon the men of old. Tonight,
it's
a question of that hoy that has dried, and you never knew.
Amen.
And it has been struggle and struggle. Some will wake up in the night, they want to pray, they struggle. Some will even come to their phones and begin to watch film. Can you imagine? They have lost appetite for the things of God. They have lost appetite for the things of the Spirit. They have lost appetite for studying God's word.
What is so important? What is your Lord?
Tonight, the anointing that fuels, that drives. That command movement, that compare, that make things easy, we fall upon your head tonight. In the name of Jesus, we are going to pray. Are you ready to pray? Listen to me. Jesus, after he had prayed, after praying, Bible says in Luke chapter 4 verse 14
that,
and Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit. After he has prayed, after he prayed, he returned in the power of the Spirit. Tonight, somebody is here. You will return in the power of the Spirit. You will return in the power of the Spirit. In the name of Jesus. And also, it is anointing that destroys yokes.
If anointing is not local,
it's the same oil that destroys yokes. When the oil will be coming down tonight, if there is any chains around you, if there is any chains in your life, the oil will address it. Because that oil, it's a liquid fire. A liquid fire. John baptized with water. He says somebody is coming.
When he comes,
who shall baptize? With the Holy Ghost and fire. It is tonight. Holy of God will flow. The anointing of God will be strong. The power of God will be strong. In the name of Jesus. Are things that address impossibilities. The anointing. I told you yesterday how I hide myself. Do you remember? How I kept my Bible under my clothes and I hide myself from a masquerade. How I hide myself from that Gunoko that, no. We went for evangelism. I saw it, I put my Bible under my clothes. And I hide. Hey! It was like Peter. You are like one of them. You speak and you look like them.
He said, never.
If I am one of them, something should happen. He began to deny because Pentecost has not come. Because the anointing has not come. Is that Saint Peter? As he was speaking, Bible says, and he was filled with the Holy Ghost. And he spoke to the Sanhedrin. And Bible says they perceived that this one, has been with Jesus. The only language this world understands now is the anointing. The only language this generation understands now is the power, is the anointing of God. Tonight, for the generation to hear you, your words must carry anointing. Your voice must emit fire. The fire of God must go with your words. And my speech and my presence. And not with the enticing words of man's wisdom. But with the demonstrations of spirit.
Power.
Jesus said, behold, I give up to you power. I didn't send you to test for it. I didn't send you as historians. I should be telling philosophies. That should be telling stories.
Show a man so it on.
Behold!
PSE.
Behold!
PSE.
Behold, I give unto you power. I give unto you the oil. Behold,
oh,
the anointing,
oh,
possibilities,
yes,
things that men have found impossible. To step in,
and it becomes
possible. They brought one woman.
While
in the meeting, I was preaching somewhere. I never knew. And then the Holy Ghost spoke to me. And I said, I see there is one woman here. I see pregnancy. And I see a child that does not move, a dead child. And right instantly, the woman came out. Said, for how long? He said, for 2 months now. They have done scan, they have done everything
confirmed.
Lifeless. No breathing. No nothing. They are helpless. They are moneyless. They are nothingless. Even me myself, I can't give them anything. Because silver and gold, me too don't have. But source that I have, yes, I did. I told the woman, woman, I will pray now. That is what they call resurrection power. That's the power that brought Jesus from the grave.
If
that spirit of Jesus dwells in you,
if
that spirit that brings Jesus from the grave dwells in you. He said, that spirit that resurrected Jesus, we quicken our mortal body. And right instantly, I prayed. I lay hands and prayed, commanding the baby to come back to life.
So
these are things that no medications or drugs can do. And these are the possibilities of the anointing. These are the possibilities of the power. These are things that the anointing does. After prayer, it happened in March. In April, second Friday.
Friday
in the evening, they phoned me.
The
woman has put to bed
a
bouncing baby boy. Give the glory to Jesus. Ordinarily, no man, no human being can do it. I tell you, no man, no man. No doctor, they are professionals. There's nothing they could do. But let me tell you, under God. That is why God gave the church the anointing. That's why He sent the church as responsibility specialist. The anointing of God in the church is what makes the church active. Powerful, a force to reckon with, a voice, the anointing. You won't be ordinary again. You won't be ordinary again. You won't be ordinary again.
In the name
of
Jesus.
Why do they say Jesus, when Lazarus died, Jesus, if you had been here, Lazarus would not have died. Are there no men around them? Are there no Pharisees living in that town? Are there no Sadducees living in that town? Are there no Sanhedrin living there? They waited for him alone. Tonight, by the reason of what is coming, by the release of the anointing, for generations are waiting for you. They are waiting for you. They want to hear you. In the power of the Spirit, he returned the power of the Spirit. He returned in the power of the Spirit. He returned in the power of the Spirit. How God anointed him. With the Holy Ghost and power. The anointing is a difference. Mark chapter 7, verse 28 and 29. We are praying now. Shatala bakuru buseteri makaya. Eri bakushete liba rodianta rababaya. Ikada badugudia shate likanda rababaya. Are we there? Mark chapter 7, verse 28 and 29. Can someone read for me? Sir?
Mark chapter 7, verse 28
and 29. Yes,
Lord.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
No. Matthew chapter 7. Is it Matthew? Matthew. Chapter 7.
Matthew, what did you do?
These people were astonished at his doctrine. For he taught them as one that has authority. Has authority. And not as the scribes. You know that is the separation. They may have the same degree. But I want to tell you. This world is ruled by decree and not degree.
Aye, and darire pelu
decree
pelu ofin ashe.
It symbolizes power.
Ofi oje abara
and not degree.
Yeshe.
Demons have no respect for grammar. Demons have no respect for grammar or degree.
Yeshu. Ojuwo iwe hita.
It is the anointing.
Oje ifamoronya.
Jesus, we know. God, we know, but who are you? The anointing. Jesus was anointed.
Jesus Christ.
God was anointed. Who are you? You see the indispensability of the anointing. It makes the person useless when you don't have it. It makes the person useless, meaningless. But as we are gathered in this house tonight, and as we pray, the anointing will come, the oil will flow, the power will come. In the name of Jesus. They sang it, they said, they were gathered in the upper chamber, as commanded by the risen Lord. They were gathered in the upper chamber. They were gathered as one gathering. Unto you, O Lord, shall the gathering of your people be. Father, tonight, glorify yourself in our midst. Oh, God of the anointing. Oh, God of power. For you that belongs to the anointing. Bible says Jesus said, all power in heaven and on earth has been given unto me. God of power, God of the anointing, the Spirit of God, the power of the early church, the power and the force of the ancient church, the supernatural force behind every supernatural works. The Holy Ghost is the supernatural force behind every supernatural works. The anointing is the supernatural force behind every supernatural works. So tonight, Emmanuel is here. The God that dwells in the midst of his people. The God that dwells in the midst of his people. The God that lives in the midst of his people. He's in our midst tonight. He said, those who seek me, they will find me. Unto you, O Lord, this gathering is unfold. God, glorify yourself tonight. Let's rise to pray our feet as we pray. Are we ready to pray? I want us to cry tonight. I want us to pray tonight. Luke chapter 3 verse 21. Luke 3:21. Somebody just help me to read. Luke 3:21. When all the people were baptized, it came to pass. Listen very well to that word. Jesus also came to be baptized. Guy, and what? And what? Can I hear you now say it loud? Can I hear you say it loud? And praying. Others have come. He said they have come to be baptized. He said, behold, Jesus also came to be baptized. I'm praying. What happened? Pusha. Kilamata Kuri Basanda. The heaven was open. Heaven burst open. While one man was praying. Are you ready to pray tonight? Please, I want you to pray. The Lord, if you anoint anybody here tonight, if you are here to pour oil on anybody, I don't want to be a natural Christian again. I want to be commanding power. I want to be walking in power. I don't want to be a natural Christian. Father, release the oil of power. The oil came, the power came, the fire came. Yes, that is what happened. He prayed. Heaven opened. When your heaven opens, your heart will happen.
What
heart? Yes. When your oven opens, your heart, the heart here, we happen. It will happen. Are we ready to pray now? As we gather unto him, Father, in one voice tonight, Bible says they were gathered in the upper room, 120 persons, and suddenly, Jah came a sound from heaven. Father, let our own sound come tonight. Let our own fire come tonight. Let the dove come tonight. Let the power come tonight. Somebody open your mouth and announce for God. Oh God, anoint me tonight. Oh God, anoint me, Jesus of Nazareth, with the Holy Ghost and power. Anoint me tonight. Oh, open your mouth and pray. Oh God, anoint me tonight with the Holy Ghost and power. Anoint me tonight with the Holy Ghost. Anoint me.
You are gathered in the hall, Bashiru, as commanded by the risen Lord. They are waiting for the promise. When the Holy Ghost from heaven descended to Let a fire fall from heaven. We are waiting and expecting. Now in faith, dear Lord, we cry out.
let the fire fall, let the fire fall on the promise we depend. From the glory of thy presence, let the Pentecostal fire descend. Lord, send down the fire, send down your fire, send down power. Anoint me tonight, oh, yeah, with the Holy Ghost and power. Anoint me tonight with the Holy Ghost and power. I want to see all possibilities in God. I want to touch the realm of possibilities. I want to touch the realm of supernatural. Anoint me, oh God, with the Holy Ghost and power. It has a fire. Yema sheka tela mana mana kayaba. Yema sheka laburi kasida gakata. Yeli kata robo kasida babakuria. Baida kasoida ida kuriba santa rabaya. Yeli kata puria kasaida kapuria. Yes, Lord. Oh, come in your power. Come and sit upon us tonight. Sit upon us tonight. Let that be revival, oh God. We are too weak. We are too down. We are weak, oh God. Let there be revival. Let there be restorations. Let there be repositioning, oh God. Let there be reawakening. Aya la baba baya. Aya la baka sakaraba. Aya. Emata borobo kayaba. Emata karabo kasakaya. Emata la baba bakuri bakaya. Etele morobo shenda ya nakusa. Yakusa te kapuka te. Le perreko takagadash. Le tos kalanta. Iko suke kete. Le kute reduka. Ritu suke redosha. Reduko loto. Siata kayedesh. Emba lobo sakaranto kolobo. Ritu kuta indosya. Le mo kato soka ladosha. Ise kuta. Le perado siakates. Le tosha takosa. Oh God, come very strong. Come in your power. Come in your glory. Oh God, let the oil come tonight. Oil of power. Oil of power. Oil of grace. Oil of God's possibilities and power. Come very strong tonight. Aya la baba baya, aya kasiba la baba, erika tabarabu kasaya, erabu katabaradia, inta la katozo, lezozo karadash, inta ke la barosa, rante ke puka. Oh God, let the power come, let the power come, let the power come, let the power come, let the power come. Oh God, Lord, anoint me tonight, anoint me tonight. Anoint me tonight. Anoint me tonight. Oh God. Anoint me. Anoint me. Anoint me. Let there be rain of the anointing. Let there be rain of the anointing. Let there be rain of the supernatural. Let there be rain of the anointing. Let there be rain of power. Tonight, I am the one in power. Luke chapter 10 verse 19. Behold, I give unto you power. Open your mouth and cry. Open your mouth and cry. Don't be tired. Don't be tired. Don't be tired. If there is a man to ask, there is a God to give. If there is a man to cry, there is a God to hear. If there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. Yena baba baba ba. Yekele korobo sila baba baba ba. Oh, fill us, Lord, tonight. We are gathered, O Lord. Unto you we gather tonight. Anointing of God. Come strong tonight. Shakata baseke rebo kata. Ezo kolota zanta la kapuria. Intaka lado shagagagas. Kuse leketozi alamakus. Yes, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord Jesus. Eketalo shadira basante. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory be to your name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Sir,
keep asking. Tonight, we are here for him. And we appear here in our midst. He is here right at the center of this place. Those who seek me shall find me. If there is a man to cry, there is a God to hear. If there is a man to ask, there is a God to give. If there is a man to pray, there is a God that answers. Tonight, you are going with the fullness of God's anointing. You will be released from this place with the flame of fire. In the name of Jesus. Now, I want us to quickly set you a very critical issue in case you are still living inside in sin. These are things that quench revival fire. You know, you have some addictions in you that you cannot remove. You have been trying to fight, but you can't just tell. There's a yoke of sin, there's a yoke of lying, fornications, evil thoughts, and all manner of things. Masturbation, smoking, and secreting, and all kinds of evil things. You are here tonight, you want to settle the matter fast. All eyes closed. Just lift up your hand. The Lord is about to help. God wants to help. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Those ones whose hands are lifted, please find your way to the front. I just want to pray. We want to pray together. Let's pray together. Just try and come to the front and let's pray. Just let's pray. Let's pray tonight. So that you will not be left out in the move of the anointing. So that you will not be exempted from the hands of God that is moving around this house. Come to this place now. Thank you, my brother. God bless you. Thank you, my sister. God bless you. It is tonight. Honor our humble gathering. Oh God of mercy, honor our humble gathering tonight. Let there be answer to our cry. Let the anointing of God come very mighty. Anoint our head with oil. Oh God of power. Everyone of you at the front, just say after me. Jesus, I surrender my life to you. Place your hand on your chest. I surrender my life to you. Save me tonight. I'm a sinner. Save me. Save me, Lord. Save me, Lord. Save me, Lord. Save me from sins. From the yoke of sin. Save me, Lord. Tonight, I surrender to you all. All that I have, I surrender. Surrender my life to you. I know I'm a sinner. I am guilty as charged. Save me, O Lord. Father, write my name in the book of life tonight. Make me your home, make me your child. Purge me with your blood. Cleanse me tonight. Thank you, mighty Father. Glory be to your name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. God bless you. You can go back to your seat. You can see our pastor after the meeting. Thank you, Jesus. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Let it happen again tonight. Let there be rain of revival here again. Let there be flow of the anointing here again. Let there be move of your power here again. As it happened in the day of Pentecost. As it happened in Azusa Street Revival. Oh God, do it again in our time and do it again tonight. Let the oil of God come. Fire fall on me. Fire fall on me. Like on the day of Pentecost. Fire fall on me, like on the day of Pentecost. Fire fall on, hallelujah, like on the day of Pentecost. Fire fall on, hallelujah, like on the day of Pentecost. Fire. Aya la baba ya. Aya ko se ke te ni manana na. Yeso ke le moro ko kanda ya la baba ya. Oh, like on the day of Pentecost, fire fall on me. Hallelujah, like on the day of Pentecost, fire of God, the oil of God, the liquid fire. Oh, like on the day of Pentecost, fire fall on me. Oh, like that. I want you to be serious with your cry tonight. Fire. Father, hear our cry. Let there be rain of your power. Fire of God. Aya la baba kuri ba santa raba. Oh, my God, thank you, Father. Yes, Lord. 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 Yes. Yes, fill them, fill them, fill them, fill them, fill them, fill them again. Fill our emptiness, 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 oh God. We are empty. We are sincerely empty. Oh God, fill us again. Fill us again. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I want to see your glory. I want to offer this sacrifice of praise. You deserve, oh Lord, with your spirit once again. Be filled. Be filled. Be filled. Be filled. Be filled. With the anointing. Be filled. Be strengthened the God. Be revived the God. Be restored the God. Oh God of restoration. Oh God of revival. Oh God of anointing. Oh, look at our sincere hearts. We are sincerely crying of our weakness. We are powerless, we are useless. Oh God, come upon us. Come and sit upon us, oh God. Oh God, let not the enemy mock the judge. Let not the enemy mock our uselessness. Come and sit upon us, oh God. Be filled. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Shelika time. Eidaka saida baya. Kuriba saida yaya. I feel the presence of God so strong. Roma sata ya kuriba sata ya. Anointing, anointing of God, anointing of God. From tonight, the feeble becomes strong. From tonight, the feeble becomes strong. The weak becomes strong. The dying be revived. Every glory that has departed, prayer altar that has gone down, prayer fire that has gone down. Tonight, that arm is lifted up. It's lifted up. It's lifted up. It's lifted up. In the name of Jesus. The anointing of God, that liquid fire, that liquid flame, be released upon everyone. In the name of Jesus. From this moment, every impossibility around you, at your appearance, they shall become possible. Every impossibility around you, anything that man, machine, material, whatever, business that are dead, as you appear, they shall be revived again. They shall come alive again. They shall gain their strength again. In the name of Jesus. Anything you touch, Bible says we shall lay hand on the sick, and the sick shall recover. This day, from today, this scripture shall be fulfilled. Because of the anointing. Because of the anointing. Because of the anointing. Because of the anointing. Said, and by the anointing, yokes shall be destroyed. Every yokes of barrenness, every yokes of stagnation, every yokes of satanic possession, affliction, torment, curse. As soon as you hear of me, you shall obey me. Strangers shall submit themselves unto me. Strangers shall fade away and be out of their close places. I command everything inside of you that God has not planted out in the name of Jesus. Anything consistent headache at the forehead, high blood pressure, hypertension, hypotension, lameness, weakness, numbness, deafness, 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 there I rebuke you. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Partial blindness, cancer, malfunctioning kidney, liver that is dying, weak, a weak heart, cancerous stresses of sickness, I rebuke you. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Creative miracles. Creative miracles. Things that never imagined before. Doors that are closed against you by the force of grace and power. Be open in the name of Jesus. Every great, wonderful things you are longing for, by the flow of the anointing of God, they are released into your hands. They are released into your hands. Possess your possession. 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 Possess what belongs to you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. From this moment as you speak, the fire of God, tongue of fire, flames of God, your walls will be laced with fire. Your walls will be laced with flames. In the name of Jesus. No attack of the enemy will apprehend you. No forces that torment you in the night will come back again. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty God. Can you give God praise for what he has done? He's done great things. Give God praise, give God praise. Give God praise. You can appreciate God better. You can appreciate God better. You can appreciate God better. Let's wave unto the Lord for what he has done.